Hey, what's up, guys? What's up? So I want to talk to you a little bit about Romblon. Before I get into it, this is my old phone, the old Moto. Anyways, I'm going to start using it over Wi-Fi. Got the little adapter thing, so I put it on my tripod so I can be like Barry. You know, because he's my hero. Anyways, you know, and I just want to have high quality footage like he has. You know, he has this amazing ability to use a phone and just have high quality, crystal clear, excellent lighted, professional videos. And I want to try and see if I can do it like he does it. And, you know, to be able to do it with, you know, now I can use my old phone, which is still pretty good. I just changed carriers. I don't use the phone. Got this, I can hook it up to my tripod. Now, I don't have a high-end high tripod like Barry has. You know, this one is a carbon fiber, but I need to go pull out my three-legged thing. You know, the high-end tripod that I have, the $400 tripod. Because this isn't up to standard like Barry has. And so that's just kind of where I am. And kind of my passion right now is to have high quality, high content videos just like he has. You know, okay, all joking aside, I'm filming this on my oldest camera that I still have. This is the Sony A5000 with a 16mm f2.8 prime lens. Typically, I'm filming with this bad boy, okay? This is the newer version of this. This is the 5100 with the Samyon 12mm f2 lens. But I wanted to pull it out and use the old system just to try and see, make sure everything's running smoothly with it. Okay, so what's the truth about Romblon? Well, the fact of the matter is, St. Augusta, or, you know, it would be St. Augustine in U.S. language. It's a small town. There's nothing there. There's literally nothing there. It's like 3 blocks long and 3 blocks wide. There's a karaoke bar across from the wharf, and there's a bus terminal, which is a dirt parking lot behind some rice vendors. That's it. Okay. That's all that's there. I mean, I can't think of anything else that's there. Pretty much, if you want to do anything in Romblon, you have to go to the major town where all the boats come in. Other than that, there's not much really there. So, the cool thing about Romblon is that is an area. You have Romblon Island, and then you have another island out by where San Fernando is. That island is amazing, okay? Really, really cool. And by the way, there's a bunch of treasure, sunken Japanese ships in those waters. I think it was Microsoft that found one of them, okay, that brought it up. So, as crazy as that is, that's kind of... Now, if you go to the south of the island of Tablas, forget the town. You can take the little boats, the little with the side bars on them. I forget the name of those, bangas. And you take that to Caraba Island, which is right north of Boracay. It's like Boracay was 50 years ago. Really, really cool island. Just amazing place. So there is some cool stuff in Romblon. There really is. Even Tablas, I mean, it's mostly just rice paddies. Now there's some nice people. I was in, I think it was, it's called Log, L-O-O-C, and I missed the one jeepney in the afternoon to get back to the main town to leave, and just this Filipino family let me stay with them until I left in the morning. And really nice people, very, very nice people. And so, yeah, I mean, that's basically Romblon. There's not a lot there. Their airports aren't even operating right now. You got a ferry to Batangas, And I think Super Ferry comes in to go to Manila. And they may go to Batangas as well, I don't remember. So, that's really it. There's not much there. It's not a major destination. And anybody that goes to Romblon, and they're not going to that far island, I don't really know why they'd be there. Anyways, that's it. I'm out of here. See ya.